In this video, I want to answer for you, what is a geogrid? How does a geogrid ranking report work? How is it getting the data? And most importantly, why is it important to you as a business owner? So I don't want to waste any time here. I am Chris Palmer with GrayHatSEO.com. And if you received a correspondence from us that looked very similar to this, and you were wondering, what's a geogrid? How does it work? Like, why do I need this? I'm going to answer that for you as well. So let's not waste any time here. This is a geogrid. This is a geogrid, and they come in all shapes and sizes, squares, circles, triangles, all different shapes. But the fact still remains the same. Each one of these points that you see, an 8, this 5, this 13, this 11, this signifies a longitude and latitude. But more importantly, it gets more granular. Not only is it a longitude and latitude, but at this time, if you look over here to the left-hand side, on April the 8th, at 10:01 a.m., we simulated a search from this precise point on a mobile device, searching for either this key term or this key term, right? We did both. And this brought back a result of number 8. This told us that in this area, especially in the morning, probably throughout the day, that we're not performing at our best, but we're working towards it. So this is how a geogrid ranking report works. Simulating searches, desktop or mobile, from that precise location. This way, we're able to see month over month, are we doing better? Or is our proximity expanding? And we can pinpoint each key term. So this is what a geogrid is, and this is how a geogrid ranking report works. Again, when we take a look, we'll zoom out. We're looking at a large area, but each pin is, and each number on top of the pin is our rank at that time. Now, you could look at an aggregate, but we like to look at each pin, all right? We like to break down each of our keywords up to 10. So what I mean by this is if you're a head spa, spa head, maybe you're doing nails, whatever the case is, we want to track each individual key term. On top of that, we want to go very broad and see, is our proximity expanding and is our rank increasing? So proximity is this. Take a look at this. See this number 1? So from here to the 8, that's my proximity. That's how far I'm ranking. Technically speaking, the proximity would be from 1 to the 4, because these are the closest to being in the map pack. But we are looking at a 20-mile radius here, all right? So our proximity that we're tracking is 20 miles. With that being said, this is how it works. The number on top is the rank. The area in which we're going for, this is your square miles. Up in this corner here, if you're working with us, you will get a report. For instance, on April the 1st, we started here, 7.24. You can look at the report. And then on top of that, if you click on this button here, the panel, you can look at Miami or Head Spa. So you can break down each key term. We can go over here, doing horrific on that primary key term, but doing good for the broad match. We go to the very next scan. So every 2 weeks we're scanning. So on April the 8th, we did another scan. So we did Head Spa again, starting to move up. And then we did Miami Head Spa. We're going for broad match. That's what we want. This one is an additive. To add a geolocation or a modifier, in this instance, isn't what we're after, but we like to track it. On top of that, we'll go to the next month. And as you can see, they're really starting to come in now. It's been 3 weeks. We've been working together, optimizing profiles, but this isn't about optimization. It's about the report. So what we're looking at here is the tracking over time. So let's go to the last one. And that's it.